So dear students, today we are going to start a new topic, Ohm's law. So I have already drawn the diagram of Ohm's law on this whiteboard, and this law was given by a scientist whose name was George Simon Ohm. He has given the relationship between the potential difference and the current flowing through the circuit. Now, according to the statement given by George Simon Ohm, the potential difference in a circuit is directly proportional to the current flowing through it, provided the temperature remains constant. It means, if we do not change the temperature of the circuit, then the ratio V upon I is always constant according to this law. And the constant here we are using is R, which is also known as the resistance. Resistance is something that opposes the flow of charge. It is a, or we can say simply, it is a force which opposes the flow of charge in any conductor. So V is equal to IR. This is the derivation of the Ohm's law. This is very simple derivation. The ratio V, the ratio of potential difference and current, is always remains constant, provided the temperature remains constant of the circuit. Now the constant we are using is resistance R. So we can simplify, make this arrangement, V is equal to IR. Now this is a very common question which generally comes in board exams, that we have given the ratio of V and I, and we have two graph lines. This is the graph line for the first conductor and this is the graph line for the second conductor. Now the question is, which graph line has more resistance value? So simply, there is a very simple trick for doing such a question. Now let us consider any point P. Let it be of any value. Now join this point P with the axis of first point and then connect it with the axis of potential difference. Then in second case, join this point to second line and then connect it to the potential difference. So this would be the value of V for first case and this would be the value of V for second case. Now according to Ohm's law, we can see that resistance is directly proportional to the value of potential difference, V. If V will be more, the resistance will be more. So in this graph, we can see in second case, the value of V is more as compared to first case. Therefore, we can say that the resistance R2 is greater than R1, means the resistance of this object is greater than the resistance of the first object. Now we are going to discuss that what is the basic difference between resistance and resistivity. This resistivity is also called as specific resistance. Resistance is denoted by the letter capital R, whereas resistivity is denoted by the symbol rho. Simply we can say rho. Now what is resistance in any circuit? Resistance is simply defined as a force which resists the flow of charge, which opposes the flow of current, which does not allow, which does not want the current to pass through the conductor. It's called resistance. Whereas resistivity can simply be defined as the resistance offered by a conductor of unit length and unit area of cross-section. We can take an example of a cube. Now, let us consider a metallic cube of length 1 meter, breadth 1 meter and height 1 meter. So, the resistance offered by the opposite faces of this metallic cube on any current carrying conducting wire is called specific resistance or the resistivity. Resistivity depends from material to material. All the different materials have different resistivity. For example, silver is good conductor than iron because the specific resistance of silver is low as compared to iron. Now, we are going to discuss on what factors the resistance of a conductor depends. Resistance of a conductor depends on the following factors. The very first factor is R is directly proportional to L, means the resistance of any conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. More will be the length of the wire, then more will be the resistance offered by it. Second thing, resistance is directly proportional to the specific resistance of the material medium. More will be the specific resistance, more will be the resistance offered. So this would be the equation number 1, equation number 2. This is equation number 3. It denotes that the resistance of a conductor is indirectly proportional to the area of cross-section. Suppose we have two types of wires, a thin wire and a thick wire. So thick wire has more area of cross-section. Suppose this is the wire. So this thickness of the wire is called area of cross-section and it is considered to be circle. So resistance is indirectly proportional to the area of cross-section. More will be the area, means more thicker the wire, then less will be the resistance. Or less thicker the wire, then more will be the resistance. And the fourth point is resistance is directly proportional to temperature. Resistance is directly proportional to temperature. That we can see with the formula. This is a very simple formula which is denoted as rho. Rho means specific resistance is equal to M upon N E square tau. Or simply we can say rho or the specific resistance is indirectly proportional to tau. This is tau. Tau means collision time period of electrons. Suppose this is a wire and in this wire the electrons are moving from point A to point B. Now if we heat the wire, then what will happen? When we heat the wire, when we are giving the temperature, when we are giving the energy, heat energy to the wire, this heat energy gets converted into the kinetic energy, and therefore these electrons, they start vibrating from their mean position and they will undergo the haphazard Brownian motion and they start colliding each other. when they start colliding each other, then the collision time decreases. And when the collision time decreases, the resistivity increases. The resistivity increases, therefore resistance also increases. So it is very clear that if we heat the wire, then electrons gain heat energy, they get converted the heat energy into the kinetic energy, and they start colliding with each other. And when the collision time decreases, the resistivity increases, and therefore the resistance also increases. Now, on combining the equation number 1, 2 and 3, 1 plus 2 plus 3, we get R is proportional to rho L upon A. R is proportional to rho, proportional to L, and indirectly proportional to A. From this formula, we can derive the formula of a specific resistance. Now, rho is equal to A to this side, R A upon L. And now, we can derive the SI unit of the resistivity. The SI unit of resistance is ohm. The SI unit of area is meter square, and the SI unit of length is meter. Now apply the SI units. Rho is equal to ohm meter square upon meter. So this would be cancel out. The SI unit of the specific resistance or the resistivity comes to be ohm meter. Now let us consider a question on this. Question is, what would be the new resistance if now what would be the new resistance if the current carrying wire is doubled on itself? Means, suppose we are having this wire. Now from the center, we are going to make it doubled. We are going to make it doubled means its length becomes half and the thickness becomes 2 times. So according to the original case, R is equal to rho L upon A. This is the original case before doubling the wire. Now after doubling the wire, the new resistance will be R dash is equal to rho. Resistivity never depends on the length and area of cross section. Resistivity depends on the temperature only. Now the new resistance R dash will be equal to rho L by 2, because we have doubled the wire. So we have reduced the length by half, by 2A, area of cross section becomes twice, or we can write by 1. So R dash will be equal to rho L upon 2 into 2A, or R dash is equal to rho L upon 4A. Or R dash is equal to 1 by 4 rho L upon A. So in place of rho L upon A, we can substitute the value R. So R dash is equal to 1 upon 4 R. So we can see that the new resistance or R dash will be equal to 1 by 4 R. Means the old resistance becomes 4 times less. Now next question is, resistance of a metal wire of length 1 meter is 26 ohms. The length of the wire is 1 meter and the resistance as per the question is 26 ohms at 20 degree Celsius. If the diameter of the wire is 0.3 millimeter, what will be the resistivity of the metal? Now we have to find the value of resistivity. What will be the value of resistivity? Now, for attempting any numerical, the first thing we need to write whatever is given in the question. The second thing, now we need to compensate the units. We have to convert the given units into SI units. So length meter correct, resistance ohms correct, diameter is in millimeter. So we can write is equal to 0.3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters, or if we want to remove this decimal, we can write 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 meters. Now apply the formula rho is equal to Ra upon L. Now we are having R given in the question, length already given in the question, but we are not having area of cross section. So before finding out the resistivity, we need to find out the area of cross section. Now what is the area of a circle? Previously you are using pi r square to find the area of a circle. But here for our convenience, we are not using this formula. We are using pi d square by 4. Both are same, but this would be more convenient. As diameter is given in the question, so no need to convert the diameter first into the radius. Directly apply this formula, pi d square upon 4. Now area of cross section would be pi 22 by 7 into d square, means 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 square by 4. 22 into 9 into 10 to the power minus 8. When we square the exponential power, they sum up upon 28 dividing by 2, 11, 14. So 11, 9 ja 99 into 10 to the power minus 8 upon 14 meter square. Now keep it as it is. Now apply this value here. Now rho is equal to R 26 into A 99 into 10 to the power minus 8 by 14 upon L. So when we divide by 2, 7, 13. So after calculating, we get the answer 183.69 into 10 to the power minus 8, or 184 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meters. So this is all for today. And in our next class, most probably tomorrow or day after tomorrow, we will going to discuss about the arrangement of the resistances in series and parallel circuits. Thank you very much.